the session on RC coupled amplifiers. Learning outcomes are, at the end of session, students will be able to explain the operation of RC coupled amplifier as well as the parameters of the RC coupled amplifier. So these are the contents. So what this basically this RC coupled amplifier is? Here, output signal of first stage is coupled to the input signal of next stage via capacitor. And here, a resistive load of the first stage will also be acting as a load for that particular stage and will provide the signal to the next stage. Here, the stages of the amplifier are identical. So each stage is identical, that is using the same transistor and uses the common power supply. This particular coupled, this RC coupled amplifier is widely used in the voltage amplifier since it has excellent audio fidelity over the wide range. But here, due to the shunting effect, so shunting effect is due to the capacitor. And as you know that when frequency is large, at that time you will get the XC value small, and due to this shunting, total gain is less than the product of individual voltage gain. And that's why here we will see the next. So this figure 1 shows the circuit diagram for the RC coupled amplifier. Here voltage divider biasing is used. This resistor, that is collector resistor, will provide the input to the next stage, that is base of the transistor Q2. So we are using here voltage divider biasing, and emitter resistor is also playing the role to make the Q point stable. Okay. So here Cm couples the AC signal voltage, and Ce will provide the low reactance path. Ce is the bypass capacitor, and the coupling capacitor Cc passes the AC signal and blocks the DC signal. Now we will see the operation when input signal is fed to the first stage, which will be amplified by the transistor, which will appear across the collector transistor, further given to the base of the next stage. So this coupling capacitor couples the output of first stage to the input of next stage. So I can say the overall gain is equal to voltage gain of first stage into voltage gain of second stage. But as I told you before, due to shunting effect, there will be loss of the gain, and therefore it will be practically less than the multiplication of two voltage gains. See, this is the circuit. We can represent this circuit in the simplest form for the analysis purpose, and that we can do with the help of the H model. Okay, as you know well that H parameter is used to represent this transistor. So here this is the coupling capacitor in between the two stages. This is the input impedance of the second stage, and this is RC, which is the output impedance of the first stage. So we can say as HRE of the transistor is small, therefore HRE into Vout is neglected, which is at the input side of the transistor, and 1 by HO is very large, which is parallel to this particular output part of the transistor, which is also neglected. Therefore, circuit becomes simply with this particular arrangement. And R1 and R2, which are used for the biasing purpose, which are large as compared to HIE, since we have just this particular representation. So we have used the emitter bypass capacitor, which is also small. So RE and CE considered as short circuit. Okay. So if we analyze this further, we will get the frequency response of the RC coupled amplifier. So here what I have done, I have converted this particular current source into the voltage source. Therefore, it will be HFEIB into RC in series with the RC. Yes, and this is shown over here. Now, one more thing, capacitor, as it is a mid frequency analysis, we are considering for the XCC value is very, very small as frequency is moderately large. So, we have this current flowing through the output path or this loop is equal to HF into IB into RC, which is a voltage source, upon RC plus HIE. RC is the first stage collector resistance and HIE is the second stage input impedance. So, this is my I. Now, I can say AIM, that is mid frequency current gain, equal to I upon IB, that is output current by input current. So, I will get this particular equation, since I upon IB will be giving you this remaining ratio. Now, to calculate I out, I can say it is simply the current flowing through the path into HIE. So, I will just multiply the value of I with this HIE. Next, Vin equal to what? Input impedance into input current, that is HIE into IB. Why I am calculating this? Because I am interested in the voltage gain, which is AVM. AVM is what? Voltage gain at the mid frequency. So, this is my AVM. Now, when I consider the low frequency signal is applied, at that time XC will come into picture. We cannot ignore it. Therefore, same is the thing which we have carried forward. Just the additional part is I have minus JXCC part over here due to this coupling capacitor. So, see here, when I do this calculation and I calculate the voltage gain for the low frequency, I will come across this particular ratio. Now, with this, I will also calculate my modulus of this gain, which gives you this equation, and through this, I will now calculate the cutoff frequency, lower cutoff frequency, means from which particular point I will get the constant output voltage. See here, this is the ratio of AVM and AVL, that is AVL by AVM. As you know that it is 1 by root 2 always, that is AVL equal to, or any lower cutoff frequency equal to what? Mid frequency range by root 2. Therefore, if I analyze it further, I will come across this particular equation, that is 1 by 2 pi cc into RC plus HI. In the same way, if I go for the high frequency, at that time my inter electrode capacitors will come into picture, which gives my inter wired capacitance. Therefore, I treat it as CD, okay, that is depletion capacitance. And when I go it further, I will again have the same procedure which we have done in the low frequency analysis, and I will calculate my high frequency gain over there. Why it is so? Because only the CD will be changing over there, okay. This J omega CD will be extra in that analysis, and when I get the ratio of AVH by AVM, which is again equal to 1 by root 2, I will take it as the ratio, and when I compare this part equal to the higher cutoff frequency, so I can write 1 by 2 pi CD into bracket 1 by HI plus 1 by RC. This is my high frequency gain. So, when I get the two different identical stages, one with the same values of RC, Rin and the voltage gain, so calculate the gain in dB. As I know that effective load for the resistance has to be calculated, which is a parallel combination of RC and Rin, which comes to 333. And so, I have the gain of four stage, which is equal to 16 to 333 by 500. Means what? Gain of the second stage is 60, but my gain of the first stage will be reduced due to the loading effect, and that's why I will not get the 16 to 60, but 16 to 39. Therefore, it is 2397. So, this is the frequency response over the mid range and the high and low frequency range. And the advantages of this is that we have the excellent frequency response over audio frequency, which is giving the cheap solution, and the disadvantages are lower voltage and power gain as well as noisy because we are using resistor and capacitor, which also gives the poor impedance matching. It is used in the public address system. These are the references. Thank you.